Hey everyone, Mr. Obermeyer here. Let's try some different things out here. Got to have a little bit of music there. Want to thank 3 Days Grace, okay, from my Pandora radio station, kind of leading us into this introduction video that I want to make. So let's get on to it. There are so many times now that we are using Teams and we're using information, we're using terminology that we just, what I say, I need to make sure that you guys understand. That's the important part here. So I want to make this tutorial. I'm going to go through, I'm going to bring up my Teams page on the next screen here, and I want to show you what the different options are and the different, when I use terminology and what I'm referring to when I talk to you in class and what the different areas are. All right, so let's go ahead. Let's get started. So you'll see right over here, okay, we have, okay, a normal Teams page, all right? This is my third period. It's my athletic training class, so I wanna thank them, even though they didn't realize that I'm doing this. But I wanna show you kinda how I've been setting up, okay, our Teams page here. So, we have a lot of different icons within Teams itself. Now, this is the Teams desktop app. That means that there is the icon. Okay, this is your desktop here, your regular stuff. These are all your icons and your apps. Okay, so if I was to, I'm gonna go ahead and close this down. Okay, this is my Teams desktop app. So we can see it right here. I'm gonna double click on it. I'm going to open it up. Give it a few seconds to load. Oh, there it pops up for me. And there we have it. Okay. So I'm going to go up here. I want it to fill the screen for me. Okay. And it brings me back really right to where I left off. Okay. Back into my Teams page. Now you see that it is the black screen. Okay. This is called the dark mode. It's supposed to be easier on your eyes. And you're spending hours on hours looking at the screen. Okay, there's a couple of different ways that you can change that. And right now, I'm just in my general area for Teams. Okay, if you go up, okay, to the gear wheel, you highlight that, you can see it's right here in the right-hand corner. You click on that for more options. I want to manage my team, or actually, I want to switch my view. Okay, so when you switch your view, it brings up the settings area. Okay. Like I said, right now I'm in the dark mode. Okay, when you do it on the default mode, which a lot of you are probably in, you'll notice that it's in the white screen and it changes it white. It's a little brighter. So if you find yourself where your eyes seem tired, okay, at the end of the day, maybe you're getting headaches. Okay, you might think about switching to the dark mode. All right, it's easier on the eyes, it's less bright coming at you. All right, they also have a high contrast. I'm not a huge fan of that. The yellow, okay, for me is very distracting, okay, but you can kind of play around with that. All right, and then, so I'm gonna go back to the dark mode here. That's the theme. If you go to the next area down, the layout area, you'll see grid and you'll see list. The grid is this view, where all your teams have nice tiles. Okay, it's easy to see. You can organize and move them around to areas that maybe you go to certain ones more often than not. Okay, in this day and age, we're in a lot of different teams areas. Okay, so I like to have my classes the first thing that I see when I'm looking at my Teams page, and then some of these other teams that I'm a part of, okay, I have them available. I also have some hidden teams. Okay, hidden teams are ones that I don't go to on a regular basis, but they're still important, and I need to make sure that I have them. I don't want to delete them. I don't want to leave them. Okay, I still want them there, and I'll still get the notifications for them. But it's teams that I don't go to on a regular basis. All right. So again, this is the grid view. Okay, the list view, I challenge each of you to try it out. It looks like this. So again, for me, this is very, there's a lot of information on the screen, and I don't necessarily like all this information on the screen. I want to see, when I'm looking at a certain team, that's the one I want my attention on and I want my focus on. Okay, so I don't prefer the list view. Now, with all the different teams, you can click on two. Okay, you can see though, even though I clicked on two, it didn't change what team I'm on. I'm still in my, and I've got my icon there for my advisory period. I'm still in my advisory period, okay, for the general part. But I wanted to go into period two. I then have to move to general, the general channel, my basic channel, okay, in order to get to it. So this is another reason that I prefer the grid view. Okay. And now, let's say I'm in this list view. Okay. The wheel's not up in the upper right-hand corner like it used to be. It's moved down here to the bottom. So I need to make sure that I know where it's at. So now it's at the bottom. I want, again, I like to switch my view. I like the grid view. That is better for me, and that's what I choose. Now, the next section is the application section. Okay, if you read this, to restart, right-click the team's icon in the taskbar, then select quit, then reopen team. Okay. This one right here, auto start application. If this is checked, anytime you turn your computer on, Teams is going to pop up. If that is what you want, please check that. I don't want that. I want to open up Teams when I open up Teams. So I am unchecked that. Okay. The section, and you can check each one of these, okay, as you want it. Okay, the third one on close, keep the application running. I don't need the application running when I'm not on it. So I have unchecked that. And that may be unchecked in your screen. Two that I do like are these last two. Turn on meeting experience, which means new meetings and calls will open in a separate window. So whenever I have an actual team, okay, a live class session, I have two screens going. I have my Teams page where I can look at assignments, I can look at announcements that I've posted, I can look at all the channels that I have on the Teams page. But I also have, okay, a second box open up, okay, where I can look at the members that's in the class. So I like that. So that's why I have that check there. Okay. And you can go back through and change that. Okay, there's the privacy setting. Okay. Notifications. Some of you are getting notifications all the time. And you want to turn that off. Okay. Anytime somebody posts a chat, anytime a teacher posts an assignment, you get the dialogue that will pop up down in the bottom section right here. And that can get kind of annoying after a while if that's not something that you want. You can play here, okay, and you can actually, okay, change your settings. And I have it on a custom setting. Okay. So I, you know, this is where you can fine-tune your team's experience, okay, to suit your needs, all right? Devices, okay? I have a couple of different devices that I like to use for Teams. You notice right now that I don't have my headset on. Normally, okay, I have my headset. It's a Bluetooth headset. So I like to use that when I'm talking. I feel like I'm more in tune with the class. I can hear it right here. It makes it feel better. So you can adjust if you have multiple, different kinds of audio devices, you can make that change. Some of you have Bluetooth headsets at home. Okay, so you can actually try to connect your Bluetooth headset, okay, if it has a microphone on it, okay, to, it's got to have a microphone, okay, but you can connect it to that, okay? You can use the microphone on your computer and then have it come through your headset, right? So these are some nice features, okay, that Teams has, right? So we'll go ahead and get out of that. Now, the next thing I want to do is kind of go over this sidebar over here. Okay, you have it on both the list view and the grid view. The activity is anytime somebody posts something on Teams, it's going to pop up. Okay, students have texted me, or if they send me a chat, anything in the feed, excuse me, I'm talking too much, anything in the feed will pop up here. Okay. You can change the way this does too. There's a settings feature for that. That's a settings feature, excuse me. Going back to that area there for notifications. Change it to my activity. So anything, my activity is anything that I posted. Okay. You can see that I posted it on this channel. I posted in this channel here. Okay, for some other ones, all right? So the feed is everything. My activity is just you, okay? The chat feature, the next feature down right here. The chat feature is a way that you can communicate directly with your teacher, almost like a text message, okay? In order to do that, okay, you would have to click the new chat, which is in this area right here, okay? And you just type in the name of whoever you'd like to chat with, okay? And it's going to pop up a list of people, okay? Anybody potentially that you may have talked with, you've got to try to find them, okay? Again, and see who's who. All right, so that's important. And from there, okay, that's when you can start doing your chat. So these are all the chats that I have, whether it be in a Teams meeting, whether it be direct with a student. Okay? And then certain ones, I can actually pin so that they don't go away. If these are ones that I feel like are important and I want to keep them up at the top so I can reference them a lot quicker, okay, to me that is a pinning action. And you would click, okay, the ellipsis, which are these three dots on the side, okay, and all you need to do is go down here to the third icon and select pin. And when you pin it, it moves it into a pinned area. Okay. So, the student here was talking to me. She was picking some stuff up for her class. Okay, I could pin that if I wanted to. Okay. Now let's say you're done with it. It's really not anything of value. Once it's pinned, you can unpin it. Okay. You can hide things. Okay. You can hide the message if you needed to. You can mute the message. So that way if you have this set up, if somebody talks to you, it won't come through. Okay, or it's muted. It won't be seen as easily. The Teams icon here, of course, we know this brings you to every team that you're a member of. Okay. The assignments. The assignments tab is all assignments that are assigned to you that you're a part of for every class that you're a part of. And you can see here I've got a period 3, period 5, period 6, period 2. Okay. Every one that as a teacher that I haven't returned, this is where you can go. And for your thing, these are ones that you haven't done or turned in. The return section, returned means the teacher has graded it and sent it back to you for you to look at and see any feedback, any ways that that you can correct. If you did an awesome job, okay, all the feedback that if a teacher gives you some would be in that section, and you could click on that. Okay. Phone calls. You can make calls to people. Okay, Teams is a way to again, if I call somebody, okay, it saves it, which is really nice. And the calls come actually from, okay, the chat. So let's say for this student here, Miss Ariana, if I wanted to give her a phone call, okay, and you can do this with another student. Let's say you're working on a project together. So you've got them in the chat, but you're really just not understanding something, and you want to, verbalizing it is going to be the best way to do it. You're going to click over here, and you can make a phone call where it's just audio, or you can make a video call and talk just like how you would in the class. Okay? So these are some functions that Teams has. Your calendar, of course, tells you what you've been invited to and what you have accepted. Okay. Hopefully you have all your classes up here and it'll look like that. But this is a general way that you can find stuff on Teams. Files. Okay? Things that you have, things that you've looked at. Okay? You can move stuff into your OneDrive. You can download things that maybe you want to look at again. There's a lot of different things and files. And then, of course, okay, there's these apps. Okay, you can go to a bunch of different apps here and be able to get them. Let's see if we go to stream. Okay, it brings up another icon. Okay. Let's go ahead and let's move it. Oh, so these are pinned. This one is unpinned. So I'm going to go back into Teams. You see, I went back up to Teams and went away. So that's just a way that you can do it. Right? I now want to go into a team. Okay? So I'm going to go into just my advisory team. And I'm going to go over some different terminology and names within a team itself. Okay, a team is a group, a class. How, you know, if we use it in the old terms of school, the word team means your class, the class you're enrolled in. Okay, so here's the title of the class, and then in this section. And I have, these are called channels. Okay, and in many of your classes, you have probably 4 to 5 different channels that you can navigate through. All right. Everyone, and these are preloaded in. Teachers can add additional channels if they choose. But there's some basic ones that are there. And one of them is called general. Let me actually go into another team, so that you can see the ones that are very common for classrooms. So you have the general one. Now you can look here. I've got a lot of different channels that I've added to make it easier for students to find things. This helps me stay organized and ultimately should help you stay organized. So many times I will say, okay, students, please go into the Imago platform channel, and you should know, okay, it's channel, it's going to be on the left side here, Imago platform, I could click on that, and it's going to take me to a different area, different screen. Okay? This all depends on how your teacher wants to set up their teams, but these are channels. Now, within a channel, we have different tabs, and tabs are what we have up at the top. Okay, all these different tabs here, and they're Different areas. Think of this like a filing cabinet. So each of these is a drawer. We're thinking about a filing cabinet. Okay. In each drawer, there are different files. We have a posts, files, class notebook, assignments, grades, and then teachers have the ability to add more tabs. Okay, depending on how, again, they want to set up their classroom. Okay, their team's classroom. Okay. Most teachers are using the post quite a bit. This is where we're putting information that we think is important, you need to know, that we want you to be aware of, and that has value to you. So you should be looking at your posts on a daily basis at a minimum. Okay. And you can see, hey, okay, we can scroll, okay, and move through. Now, this is where it can get challenging at times, because anything that the teacher posts as a conversation or an announcement, okay, in this general channel is safe. So if you're trying to find something, let's say way back when, all right, it's starting to think right now. Look, semester one has come to an end. Okay, that was 2 months ago. But this is, let's just say you're trying to find an announcement 2 months ago. You can actually save the message. So if you think it's going to be important, if you think it's something that you're going to need later on, I suggest you either save it. And what I did was I clicked on the, I went to, you go up to the upper right of the announcement, and you see you can like, when you can post, if you like the post, you love it, you laugh at it, the different emojis that it has. But again, we go to the ellipsis, the three dots. Let's say I want to pin it. I'm going to pin it. This message will be pinned for everyone who views this channel. So that means that anytime you go to this channel, this message is going to be the first one that people see. I don't want to do that. Let's say I want to save it. Okay? Maybe you don't have that option. Let's save this message. Okay, it's saved. Now, let's see. We can find it. I'll have to come back to that because I've yet to save the message and try to find it again. So let's see. We'll come back to that one. I want to make sure I can figure it out. But you can see, oh, if you saved it, you can see I'm struggling right now too to try to figure out where did that go? Okay, I'm not sure. Here's the other nice thing. These things have immersive reader. Immersive reader makes it big. You can click on that. Okay, and it'll actually make a sound. All right.
James Obermeyer, Thursday, February 4th, 2021,
8:42 a.m. Boys and girls golf. Anyone interested in trying something different and building fun with a great sport, think about golf.
So you see how it reads it to you? Now let's say we want to try to read it into a different language. Okay, so here I've got the text preference, the size of the text, so maybe it's not big enough. I can actually go in here and I can translate it to a language. So the book, okay, let's choose a language. Let's say Spanish. Okay, and with Spanish, Latin American. Let's see if there's a Spanish Mexico. I don't know enough about foreign language, but let's go and check it and see what it does. Go and X that. Let's see.
No experience necessary. And
Maybe I didn't save. Word. So I had to do it by the document there. I had to flip that switch, and now you see, okay, that I flipped it. It converted it into into Spanish. So let's play it.
James Overmyer, el jueves 4 de febrero de 2021, 8:42 a.m. Boys and Girls Golf. Cualquier persona interesada en probar algo diferente y construir diversión con un gran deporte, piense en el golf.
So there's the original. I can do it into Spanish, okay? Or any other language for that matter. Let's do.
James Obermyr a jeudi 4 février 2021 8h42. Golf garçon et fille. Toute personne intéressée à essayer quelque chose de différent et de construire du plaisir à...
Now, since I am not a linguist, I couldn't tell you how well that was translated. But it's an option that's there to help students out and to help people out if there's an issue. Maybe your parents, okay, are bilingual, and their first language is something other than English. This is a way that they can listen to it and it might make more sense to them. Okay, and now you and your parents are working together, okay, to come up with ways to fix things. All right. So I just wanted to make this video, okay, to kind of let you know the different areas within Teams. All right. We've got post files of where you can, where the teacher will put files for you to be able to look at that are important. Okay. The class notebook tab is a direct link to OneNote for this class. Many teachers are using it. It's important to know how to use OneNote, and I'll make another video demonstrating the use of OneNote in various forms coming from Teams. Assignments is a great place where any assignments that have been assigned, returned, all you have to do is click on these. You see how it hides it, okay? But it's still there. Look for check marks. Check marks means that it's been returned, that there's grades. You shouldn't have any drafts yet. These are all the different categories, okay? Grades. You can actually see if a teacher is putting grades in through, okay, through assignments, if it's there. Okay. So I don't want to show too much on that, at least for privacy reasons. Okay. But I want to show you that when we talk about certain things, these are tabs. Think of them like individual file folders, okay? Or sections, think of it like sections in your notebook. Okay, if you've got an old binder, okay, and you've got these divider tabs, okay, a tab is the same thing as what we're seeing up top. So we're trying to use, I'm trying to use the same words, okay, that many of you are familiar with. Okay, these channels are just different drawers. That's what they're for. Okay, so look at them. Okay, they're not there just to hold space. Click on them. See what you see, okay? Look, in each channel, it has more tabs, okay? So look through what your teachers are putting in here. Because if they're putting it in there, there's a reason that they're doing it, okay? To make things easier for you, right? That's all we're trying to do with Teams, and I know it can be confusing. So I just want to kind of come back, and I want to end this video just by saying that I know this is late, and I know that I should have done something like this sooner. And if you're seeing this now for the first time, and it's the middle of the semester, it's my apologies. I will continue to work to make it where you have an understanding regarding the technology and what is being said through this virtual platform. And if you can use this to teach somebody that's younger than you, somebody that's older than you, okay? Anybody that might need help, any way that we can navigate, okay, navigate the world of technology and desktops and Teams and the internet, all of these different things. Okay, if we can find ways to navigate through this together, we'll be in a much, much better place. I'm having fun with this program. This is something new for me. But this is here. This is for me. This is for you. I'm hoping you can see it. Here is my email. James.Obermeyer@FresnoUnified.org. Again, James.Obermeyer. Let me make that dot just a little bit bigger so it's easier to see on the screen. Okay. @FresnoUnified.org. All right. I'm still learning this. It's a good thing I am not on TV. If you have had Mr. Ruiz, this is not a good video, but it's a fun video and it's a start. All right. I want to thank everybody for watching. Okay. It means a lot to me that we can try to work through this together. I look forward to the questions, the comments, and I want to thank everybody again. Have a wonderful evening.